Welcome to my channel. I am the Sharon Taylor, number one storyteller, aka Jesus baby. How do you do? Talk to me now. Hi guys, I hope you enjoyed my intro song. It sucks though, I know. Today we are talking about how to face your fears and start a YouTube channel. As the case may be, as a matter of fact, you might not want to start a YouTube channel, but basically you're trying to face a fear, whether it's to write a professional exam or to start that business or to travel, to have different fears that you're trying to face every other day. And guys, guess what? This is my very first vlog. Yes. I can't believe I just said vlog. Like, I'm actually doing this. Wow, I'm proud. So basically, how to face your fears. I really want to go straight to the point. Without acknowledging that your fear exists, you're practically not going to go anywhere. You're just going to keep going in circles. I'm going to be sharing a lot of my personal experiences because I believe very much in being practical. So I'm just going to be very real with you guys. So guys, you cannot believe what just happened now. I was talking, doing the vlog, the YouTube, whatever it is they call it, and the camera just went off. Like, I didn't know. It went off at about 4 minutes and I was still talking for over 15 minutes. Real stuff, guys. Like, real life. Inside life. Is that how it used to be? I don't understand. I'm so furious, guys. I'm still trying to get over it. Like, I'm going to add this quickly to facing your fears. So you have to keep going because this life, everything will just frustrate. My God, I'm so angry. Even non-living things like camera will just ruin all your efforts. Something that cannot even breathe, that cannot even talk. Oh! Breathe, Sharon. Breathe. So guys, you cannot afford to give up. Things are going to happen despite how far you've gone. Things are going to happen that are going to want to make you give up. But you cannot afford to give up. You have to keep going. Okay, so I was talking about my personal experiences. In the process of starting my YouTube channel, I came to learn some things. So the very first thing I had an issue with was, how am I going to do all the editing, camera, lighting, video effects? Like, I'm not a very techie person. I felt like, guys, long and short of this is I was just being lazy. I was being practically lazy. Like, I'm doing it right now, right? Though it wasn't easy, but nothing good comes easy. I mean, that's the point of actually enjoying it, because you have to go through a process. And I had to face that particular fear. I had to fix it, because if I don't, I'm just gonna keep going in circles. And another fear that I had to face was, I have a bad habit. I can be a little bit inconsistent. Yeah, so what I mean really is, you can give me a soap and ask me to use it morning and night for 21 days. I just have a problem with routine. And guys, I just realized how awkward that example I gave is. I don't collect soap to be using for 21 days. Oh, let us get this thing straight. It's just a very harmless example. I don't know where it came from, but okay, I need to think about something else. You cannot ask me to drive a Porsche morning, afternoon, and night. Of course, I would drive a Porsche morning, afternoon. Guys, you get the gist. So I have a problem with being consistent with things. I can be consistent with friendships, with people, but when it comes to things that I just don't find very important, I just it still boils down to being a little bit lazy. Yeah, so that actually works together. Another fear that I really had to look into. Now guys, a lot of you have this issue too. So I can be a little bit of a perfectionist. I want everything to be set, to be in the right place. You know, It's a little bit, there's a thin line between it and starting big, but it's not exactly starting big. It's, you just want everything to be in place. And if there's a flutter, there's a little bit of an issue, you quit. And people, you realize that people who just pick things up and go, they are already going far, and you're still on this thing. It's not bad. No, it's not clear. It's not. And you spent 3-5 years and you still haven't achieved anything. So we need to be careful, really. Being a perfectionist can actually be a fear that is working against your goal. Another thing that I found a little bit off when I wanted to start my channel was I didn't know what to talk about. Well, I decided to just start. Now, if I decided to figure it all out before starting, I probably wouldn't do it. So whatever it is you're trying to do, that new business, you haven't figured it all out yet, but you need to just start from somewhere. Yes, you'll realize it along the line. You might even be experiencing issues that are different from what you thought you were going to be experiencing, and you already wasted your time. So basically, you have to just start. That's just do it. Yes, Nike, just do it, guys. Back then in university, how many years ago now? I can't even remember, but in university, so I had a couple of friends. I don't know, you know when God just wants to help your situation but you refuse to allow him to help you? That was the case for me. So I had this problem. I had H factor. Yes. Yeah, that's it. I just said it. I had H factor and God so helped me. The friends that I had, most of them had a vowel starting their names. So they either add the O or the U or the A or the E. You know, I just had to call them often. Of course, if you have friends, you have to call them by their names. And usually I will put the H. So I'll go like Hoyeka. And she'll be like, my name is not Honyeka. Like, I can see her face right now saying this. She will be so furious. My name is not Honyeka. My name is Onyeka. And in my mind, I'm like, what's wrong with this babe? Like, why is she being so dramatic? What is the difference between what she just said now and what I just said? And she will be like, seriously, there's no difference in what you just said. But this God, very powerful, very loving God, he did not give up on my matter. One beautiful day, I went to an auditioning. So they said they were going to get back to us. So one guy called me to the side. One of the coordinators, I don't know. He called me and he said, you know, you actually did well and we should consider you for this role. And in my mind, I'm like, oh my God, thank you. That's so sweet. And wait for it. Just wait for it. But you need to work on your H factor. Guys, I froze. Like, honestly, I went from 10 to 0 in 0.00001 seconds. I froze. Like, what? What H factor? And that was the moment I knew that I had to work on it. Like, I felt like, babe, we get H. Not like H factor is a disease or anything, guys. That's not my point here, but I didn't want it. I didn't want it. So that day, God bless this guy's soul. He doesn't know what it did for me. That day, I decided that I was going to work on it. I didn't know how. Maybe I was going to get a teacher. I didn't even know what I was going to do. But I decided I was going to work. I made up my mind to work on it. So, fast forward some weeks after, I was in class. Yes, I was in lecture. Then I didn't even hear what the lecturer was saying. I was just thinking about this guy that said that H factor. I mean, this thing must be really this bad. It must be really bad because my friends have been telling me and I just thought that they were being overly dramatic and exaggerating. It must be really bad, right? So I don't even know what I was doing. I just went to the back of my lecture notes and I started writing a list of words that had A and H in front of them. So basically, this is what I did. This is exactly what I did, guys. I wrote down words on, horn, and, hand, eat, heat, off. And I just went on and on like that. And so many lessons. But another lesson, you need to be careful the kind of people you talk to about your dreams. Like, seriously. So, I was writing down these words, and I think lecture was over. People were just, you know, after class now, you just talk to your friends, just for a bit. And I wasn't doing any of that. I was just writing. So, this guy came. He happens to be my friend, a very unserious guy. And he came and he's like, Shion, what are you doing? And I wanted to ignore him at first, but I knew that he would not leave until he gets the answer to the question he was asking me. And I'm like, I'm writing. What are you writing? And I looked at him like, I have H factor, haven't you noticed? And he laughed. Right now, I can remember his face. He laughed. He laughed so hard. He's like, so you're trying to correct your H factor? I'm like, yes now. The funny thing, I don't even think it's funny. I think the painful thing, really, about what he said is he didn't mean any harm. On the contrary, he wanted to help me. Yeah, I like to believe he wanted to make me feel better because he felt like I must have been having sleepless nights about this H factor, excuse me, to have written it down like this. And to decide not to talk to anybody about it. So I was just like, you can't do anything about it now. It's your mouth. Like, that's the way you talk. What do you want to do about it? Like, you're already an adult. It's not like you're a child or anything. You're fine. Just own it. Be confident about it. At what age do you want to be working on your age factor now? And in my mind, I'm like, it's true. Like, really, like, let's be sincere. I can't work on this thing, it's part of me, ready. But I could not stop thinking about the face of this guy who had told me that I needed to work on my H factor. Of course, I didn't get a job. H factor things. So in my mind, I'm like, I'll try and work on it. But I didn't tell him. I just allowed the conversation to die there. And every other day, I kept practicing those words, consciously saying the A and the H. And today, I can tell you for a fact that your girl, the show Taylor, has got no H factor. Yeah. Be very careful the people you talk to about your dreams. Because the painful thing is, they don't, you know, if someone doesn't mean well, you know, so you don't accept their advice. But they don't necessarily mean any harm. They actually say it from a place of love. Lastly, guys, to round up, I would say pray. Honestly, there are times that we have fears that we have no idea what they are. We just know that we are scared. We are just afraid and we don't even know why. I mean, it's good if you know what your fear is. You can deal with it. But what happens when you don't even know why you're afraid? What happens? I don't know. It's really crazy. Like, I don't even know why I can't do this thing now. I have all the resources, but I'm just scared. That is where you need to pray. Guys, I believe that we are first of all spiritual being before physical. And the Bible says that we should cast all our cares to him because he cares for us. The Bible says be anxious about nothing, but in all things through prayers and supplications, make your desire, request, whatever it is, made unto God. Known unto God. So I believe if you're fighting hard, regardless of how hard you try to face your dreams, achieve your goals, I think you should pray. And on the notes, I'm rounding up. I'm so excited. I can't believe I did this. Yay! Go share my first vlog, and I hope that you guys support me by liking, subscribing, commenting. Just make me feel encouraged, though. Guys, I had so much fun doing this video. I hope you had as much fun as I did watching. I'm going to catch you on the next vlog.